Our dear viewers and listeners, we greet you all in the wonderful and precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Thank you for being a part of this Bible study from Dominion Church International. My name is John Mbazira, and we are blessed and graced to be with you today. We believe your life will not remain the same. Before we open up today's Bible study, let's open up with a word of prayer. Pastor Nathan, please, would you lead us?
Father, we thank you for your word.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for the ministration of the Holy Ghost.
Yes, Lord.
Father, you said your word is life to us.
Yes, Lord.
And where your word is spoken, your presence is manifest.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for this wonderful day, King of Glory.
Yes,
for
Lord.
Great things are happening.
Yes, Lord.
For the lives you're changing today.
Yes, Lord.
For the people that are coming back from the dead.
Yes, Lord.
For the hope that is coming to the many out there, King of Glory.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we glorify your name, King of Glory.
Yes, Lord.
Because when you're exalted, you draw men unto you.
Yes,
even such a time as this, King of Glory. We thank you, King of Glory, for we are rising up to take your word to the world that is hurting, a world that is in despair, that I might see the light that comes from Christ Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Father, we pledge and say that the glory, the honor, and the power returns to you today and forevermore.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Nathan. Today we shall be taking our reading from the book of Revelation, chapter 9. We pick it up from verse 13 all the way to verse 21. The Bible says, "Then the sixth angel sounded, and I heard a voice from the four horns of the golden altar which is before God. Saying to the sixth angel who has the trumpet, release the four angels who are bound at the great river Euphrates. So four angels who had been prepared for the hour and day and month and year were released to kill a third of mankind. Now the number of the army of the horsemen was
200 million.
I heard the number of them, and thus I saw the horses in the vision. Those who sat on them had breastplates of fiery red, hyacinth blue, and sulfur yellow. And the heads of the horses were like the heads of lions. And out of their mouths came fire, smoke, and brimstone. By these three plagues, a third of mankind was killed. By the fire, and the smoke, and the brimstone which came out of their mouth. For their power was in their mouth, and in their tails, for their tails are like serpents, having heads, and with them they do harm. But the rest of mankind, who were not killed by these plagues, did not repent of the works of their hands, that they should not worship demons and idols of gold, silver, brass, stone, and wood, which can neither see
nga tebisobola kulaba,
no hear,
newankubadde okuwulira,
no walk,
newankubadde okutambula.
And they did not repent of their murders,
baagaana okwenenya olw'obusi bwabwe,
all their sorceries,
newankubadde obulogo,
all their sexual immorality,
newankubadde obwenzi bwabwe,
all their thefts,
newankubadde obubbi bwabwe.
This is God's word for us.
Kino ky'ekigambo kyaffe olwaleero.
Let's pray.
Tusabe.
Loving Father,
Tato Mwaga,
we thank you.
Tukwebaza.
For your word.
Rechi gambo cho.
Spirit of the living God.
Moyo wa Katonda omulamu.
Here we are before you.
Tutuno maso go.
Use us as tools in your hand.
Tukoze senge bikozesebwa mikono jo.
To amplify this truth.
Okuzimbulu kusama zimagado.
To every listener.
Eri buli omatu uliriza.
Anoint us for the hour.
Tufuke kama futo raka seda kano.
Anoint our listeners and viewers.
Naba ulizo bafuke kama futa.
To receive this word.
Okutwala echi gambo chino.
With meekness and gladness of heart.
Mubweto waze nesanyu mumutima.
Father, may there be change.
Tata, lekawabelewe nchuka
chuka. May there be transformation.
Lekawabelewe kuchuka chuka.
May life come about.
Lekobulamu bukomewo.
By the entrance of your truth.
Uruwe mazimba gaga yingida mubo.
We give you praise, Lord.
Tukue tendo mukama.
And we pray.
Era tusaba.
That sanction not any word.
Titoganya chigambo chona.
To come out of our mouth. Except that which you have permitted from on high. And after all is said and done. May the honor, the glory and the praise.
Be
returned to you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Today. As we look at God's word.
Nga tutwetegereza ekigambo kya Katonda.
We pick it up from where we left last week.
Tugenda kutandikira wetu ako mawiki eri.
And when we are looking at this chapter.
Era etwali twetegereza esuule eno.
We pointed out.
Waliwo ebintu bye twetegereza.
That these activities that are listed.
Ntibi nebikolo oba ebintu byonna bye batulaga mu kyawandiika.
Or the events that happen in this book.
Oba ebintu byonna ebiriwo mu kitabo kino.
Have two aspects.
Birina ebyokuyigirako bibiri.
There is the aspect that is literal.
Ekisooka kiri kwekyo gwe kyolaba n'amaaso go.
And there is the aspect that is symbolic.
Era waliwo n'ekyo ekijja mu kifaananyi.
And last week we saw the symbolic part.
Wiiki eyita twalaba ekitundu ekyo ekiringa ekyefaananyiriza.
Which comes from all the way from verse 1 down to verse 12.
Ng'okiraba okuva mu lunyiriro olusooka paka olwa 12.
And today we now pick up on the aspect.
Era leero tutandikira ku ekyo ekirala.
That is more literal than symbolic.
Ng'ekyo kikwatagana ku ebyo by'olaba n'amaaso ga
Mubiri. Although some of the events that will happen.
Wadde ebimu ebigenda okubeera
will literally happen as they are written in the book.
Bijja kubaawo nga w'obisoma.
There are some aspects that are symbolic that you need to understand what is written.
Waliwe bimunga byo bijja mu kifaananyi nga wetaaga okutegeera ki kye bategeeza.
Today we will see.
Leero tugenda kwetegereza.
The devastating consequences of idolatry.
Obubi obuva mu kusinza ebibumbe.
Or may I put it, the futility of idolatry.
Oba obutanwa oba obutaliimu obuva mu kusinza ebifaananyi.
For many of us, when we talk about idolatry,
abasinga kufe twogera ku kusinza ebifaananyi.
What comes to mind?
Kyetutegeera
is the worship of idols.
Abasinga tumanyi kusinza bibumbe.
And when we talk about idols,
era twogera ku bibumbe bino.
For many, what comes to mind again?
Abasinga okutegeera.
As is somebody bowing before a statue.
Bamanyo omuntu okuvunnamu okusinza ekibumbe.
Now idolatry is bigger than bowing before statues.
Okusinza ebifaananyi kisinga okusinza ekibumbe.
Modern day idolatry.
Kati mu biro bitulimu bino.
Has picked on a different dimension.
Okusinza ebifaananyi kisukulumyewo.
To bowing before idolatry.
Kisukulumyewo okuvunnamu okusinza ebibumbe betumanyi.
Now let me correct myself.
Kambeko kyentereza.
Bowing before idolatry, before idols is idolatry.
Okuvunnamu okusinza ekibumbe omuntu kyabumbye ekyo nakyo kusinza bifaananyi.
But it is bigger than bowing before idols.
Naye kisukuluma ku kusinza ekibumbe eky'omuntu.
It goes to so many things.
Kikwata ku bintu ebisukkawo.
And why is that so?
Naye lwaki kijja bwe
kityo? It is because
kubanga
as humans
ng'abantu
we are always making something look big.
Tuline twagala nnyo okuzimba ekintu okukisusaawo.
In other words, we are
by nature we glorify.
Munkula twagala nyo gulumize ebintu okusinga.
So if it is not God that we are glorifying,
era etubanga tetusinza oba tetugulumiza Katonda,
then we inevitably glorify either someone or something.
Era munkola yaffe tujja kunoonya ye ekintu ekirala ekyokugulumiza.
So if it is not God,
katwe tubanga tetugulumiza Katonda,
then it is money.
Oba ojja kugulumiza kati ensimbi.
It is beauty.
Ojja kugulumiza obulungi.
It is your job.
Oba omulimu gwo.
It is the economy. It is a personality.
Oba ebyenfuna, oba omuntu yenna gw'omanyi.
Are we choose something?
Ojja kunoonya ekintu ky'okugulumiza.
It can be nature.
Oyinza okulowooza ng'osinza bitu bya
butonde. But we find, we pick on something.
Naye waliwo ekirala kye tuyiga wano.
With which we glorify.
Kye bagulumiza.
Because that is innate to us.
Kubanga ekyo kya butonde munda muffe.
Now when something becomes so important to you,
kati ekintu bwe kifuuka kya muwendo gy'oli,
that it drives your response,
nga kye kisalawo engeri gy'oyanukula ebintu,
it drives your behavior,
nga kye kisindika enneeyisa yo,
it commands your emotions,
nga kikuwalirira gwe obusimu obeeko ky'okola,
then you are worshiping
it. Awo otandise okukisinza.
So worship,
kati okusinza,
deals with us as Christ in greatness.
Chiri kufe o kusinzo obukuru.
It is us looking at something being more important.
Chiringa gwe okuba ekintu kyolaba nga kya muwendo okusinga
kebira. Someone being more important.
Obo omuntu nga wa muwendo okusinga abalala.
Than God.
Okusinga Katonda.
Now some ways are so subtle.
Enkole ezimu tosobola zitegeera.
That it takes the beckoning of the Holy Spirit.
Nga kijja kutwala omwoyo mutukuvu okulungama.
For you to be able to understand that, wait a minute.
Oloko okutegeera nti dinda ko.
I think I'm placing this one to be more important.
Ndabika omuntu ono mufudde w'omuwendo okusinga ko Katonda.
I never forget an incident.
Sijja kwerabira ekyabaawo.
I met this gentleman.
Nasisinkana omusajja.
We happened to be at a funeral.
Twali ku lumbe.
And as we began talking,
era nga tunyumyamu,
he began to give me a testimony of his life.
Nampa obujulizi obw'obulamu bwe.
Now it happened he was hit by hard times.
Yayita mu biseera ebizibu.
And during those hard times,
era mu biseera bino ebizibu,
he decided that he would not be going to church.
N'asalawo nti tajja kuddamu genda mu kusinza.
Until the times had become okay financially for him.
Paka ngembera ye echuse.
So this gentleman tells me,
omusajja ono nangamba,
that one day the Holy Spirit spoke to him.
Lunakulumu omwoyo mutukuvu yayogera naye.
And told him, even today you are not going to church?
Namubuuza ati n'olwaleero tojja kusaba?
And he said, yeah, I can't go.
Naga sijja kugenda.
So he said, why?
Lwaki?
He said, because of money.
Kubanga sirina sente.
So he asked him,
namubuuza,
who is more important?
Kye ekisingawo ku muwendo?
Is it money?
Goloza sente?
Or is it God?
Oba Katonda?
Then it dawned on him,
n'alyoka ategeera,
that in that point of time,
nti mu kaseera ako ke yalimu,
money had become an idol.
Sente zaali zifuuse
Katonda. Money was more important to him,
nga sente zisinga omuwendo,
than God.
Kukatonda.
So he would not go to congregate.
Era yagaana okuddamu okusaba.
Because he did not have money.
Kubanga yali talina sente.
You know what he told me, pastor?
Nangamba musumba omanyi.
I woke up.
Nava mu tulo.
And walked.
Nentambula bigere.
8 kilometers.
Kilometer munana.
To the place of congregation.
Niende mu kanisa.
With an extra pair of shoes.
Nga nkute engatto endala za spare.
And an extra shirt.
Nesati endala munga.
When I got to the place of congregation,
era we nali ngenda kutuuka mu kanisa,
I changed the shirt and I changed the shoes.
Nezijako esati nyambade neteekako endala n'engatto nezikyusa.
Went in and congregated.
Nenyingira ne tusaba.
And then went back home.
Era nezira ye waka.
And he did that for 1 month.
Ekyo yakikolera omwezi mulamba.
And after 1 month,
era omwezi we gwaggwako,
he told me, pastor, I saw a breakthrough in my life.
Nemuga musumba nalaba okubotola mu bulamu bwange.
It's like everything had been let loose.
Kiringa enzigi nezeggulawo.
Since that day,
era okuva olunaku,
I have seen favor and grace coming my way.
Ndabye ekisa n'okuganja nga kuyiika gye.
Because I realized,
kubanga nazuula,
that my limitation was not the lack of money.
Okukugira kwange tekwava mu butalina nsimbi.
My limitation was idolatry.
Ekyali kinnemesa kwali kusinza bifaananyi.
That testimony touched my heart.
Obujulizi obwo bwakoma ku mutima
gwange. It brought me to a place where I began to ask Holy Spirit, search me.
Ne ntuuka mu kifo ne mbuuza Omwoyo Mutukuvu.
If there be anything in me,
That
is holding something or someone above
you. Give me
the courage. Give me the strength to get rid of it. And I hope and I pray that will be your prayer today. Because as we see in today's word, idolatry is not something that God takes lightly. Our God is a jealous God.
Katonda wa.
So back to the text.
Today we are
presented with the events that follow the sounding of the sixth trumpet. And we see those events coming in from verse 13 to verse
19.
Here at the beginning, John's attention is drawn to the golden altar again. Now we saw this golden altar before. In chapter
6
and verse
9,
beneath this altar were the souls of the martyrs who were crying out for justice. And then we saw also in chapter
8
that it is on this altar where the prayers of these saints and the prayers of all the saints, in other words, the prayers that we make, it is on this altar that they are offered to God. An angel mixes this with the prayers with the incense from his censer, and then he raises this and offers this up to God. Why is the altar coming back? The Spirit of the Lord is reminding us that God is still answering prayer. Therefore, I'm calling upon you who is in a desperate situation. I'm calling upon you who is in a hopeless situation. I'm calling upon you who is in a situation that is despicable. It doesn't matter how long this has been. It doesn't matter how hurting it has been. Prayer to God can bring relief. Prayer to God will come with a response to your situation. In another portion of scripture, he says, call upon me and I will answer you. God's ear is attentive to the cry of his people. You may say, Pastor, I have cried. Pastor, I have prayed. Keep persisting in prayer. Your response will come. Your response will come quickly. God answers prayer. Because in that portion of scripture he says, I will answer you. And I will show you those great and mighty things that you do not know. He says in Isaiah, behold, I'm the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? He's the God with whom all things are possible. That prompting you feel to give up on prayer is a whisper from hell. It is a whisper from the devil. Because he understands that when a child of God persists in prayer, God will respond to that prayer in ways that are magnificent. David says, I called upon the Lord and he answered me and he delivered me. Those are wonderful testimonies in the Bible. You are the righteousness of God. Let me testify.
Daudi ajulira
wa. He says, I was young.
Nali muto.
Now I'm old.
Kati nkuze.
But I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
Sirabangako mutukirivu ngalekedwa.
Nor their children begging bread.
Nezadde lyenga lisaba omugati.
The Lord says in his word.
Mukama ayogera mu kigambo kye.
Can a mother forsake her child?
Mama asobola okuleka mwana we.
And not have compassion upon the child of her womb?
Nata sasira mwana we nda.
And said, yes, they may. But I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. Now look at those wonderful promises. He goes on to say, behold, your names are inscribed in the palms of my hand. He knows you by name. He knows you. He knew you before you were born. He knows what you're going through. Child of God, make an attempt to raise your voice. God will respond to your need. There is an altar where prayers made by the saints go before God. That's why he tells us in Hebrews that let us approach with boldness the throne of grace and mercy, so that we may obtain both mercy and grace. Now mercy gives you what you don't deserve. Now grace applies when you are guilty. Everyone that is guilty needs grace. That's why he comes back to us in Lamentation. And he says his mercies are new every morning. So the mercy God applied yesterday, he will apply a fresh mercy every day. So every day you wake up, new mercies are flowing your way. God wants you to understand that no condition is permanent. Prayer will make a difference in your life. Let's go back to the word of God. He goes on to show us that this war is God's specific answer to the prayer that has been made by the saints. Now I want you to notice the form this prayer takes, this response to prayer takes. It releases four powerful angels who have been bound. Now these are fallen angels. They have been bound on earth. They can't do anything until God permits. So I want you to see who is in charge here. Now, in response to the prayer made by the saints, these fallen angels who have been bound for centuries at the river Euphrates have now been set free to wreak havoc. You see, some of us think that the devil is in charge. He's not. He's not. Whatever he does only goes as far as fulfilling the purposes of God. That's why Paul tells us in Romans, now we know that all things work together for good for those who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. Romans 8:28. That is a scripture that encourages us. The sovereign Lord is still in control. And in releasing these angels, they are released for a timed event. They're released at a specific hour. On a specific day. In a specific month. And in a specific year that God has determined beforehand. In other words, no human power. Not demonic forces. Can change that time.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And what a mighty God we serve. You see, I often tell people there is nothing that happens that God is not aware of. Nothing takes him by accident. Now let's get back to the text and see the impact of the release of these angels. Now when these angels are released, there is mustered an army of 200 million that comes in from the east. Now, 200 million is a very vast army. Just let me give you a sample, just to give you a perspective to this. Today, as we speak, the country with the largest army in the whole world is China. And it has an active force of
2.2
million. With a reserve of
2.3
million. Of 2.3
million.
India goes next. And it has an army of about 1.3 million. Then followed by the United States. Followed by Russia. Followed by Pakistan. Iran. So when you look at all these armies, even if they all combine, they can't make up the 200 million coming from the east. Now I want you to notice what is happening. The four angels, four is a number that represents worldwide human government. So these four angels represent the force that will be gathered by the worldwide human government that will be waging war against Israel at the end time. So the angel from the east, west, north, and south, this is just a picture of the four directions of the earth, of north, south, east, and west. So we now see an army that is gathered from all the four corners of the earth. And this army will invade Israel from the east through Mount Megiddo, or what we call Armageddon. Now we shall discuss this further in chapter 16. But I want us to take our focus to the imagery of what John is depicting as the warfare as he knew it in his time. And appropriate that warfare to our current situation. When he begins to talk about this warfare, he says in a vision, I saw horses in the vision, and those who sat on them had breastplates of fiery red, hyacinth blue, and sulfur yellow.
No mulido, nechizigizigi.
And the heads of the horses were like the heads of lions. And out of their mouth came fire, smoke, and brimstone. Now look at what he's trying to say. He begins to talk about the breastplate. In essence, he's talking about armor. But he's talking about armor of various colors. Now this armor could suggest armored troops actually. You have tanks, you have missiles. And you have other vehicles of war. Now the various colors he begins to talk about. He's merely talking about the primary colors that we use to mix and come up with very many colors. So they depict two things. One, the camouflage. And secondly, the national colors of the armies that are coming together to wage war against Israel. Then he points us to their mouths. Now he's simply talking about the place where the weapons are coming out. The spot where fire is coming out. The place where smoke is coming out. The place of where the devastation is coming out. And this suggests what is going to be used in conventional weapons that they are using in warfare. And radiation and things like poisonous gases. And he says that will come into play at this time. Now he talks about tails like snakes that may injure. Now this may be a weapon that has not been used. Some commentators have looked at this to be representative of drones. Now many of the sci-fi movies that we are watching today, we are seeing a certain advancement where they are creating weaponized robotics that will be used in war. Now, to some of us, this may look like fiction. But believe me, behind the scenes, there is something creative that is being brought to fruition. And the result of this engagement, the Bible tells us that a third of mankind will be destroyed. Now I want you to see the effect after a third of mankind has been destroyed. You would expect that those that are not marked would then repent. But what is happening? Even this trumpet falls on deaf ears. So rather than softening their hearts, the plagues harden their hearts. And in verse 20 to 21, we observe that the Bible tells us that they did not repent of the works of their hands, that they should not worship demons and idols of gold, silver, brass, stone, and wood. The intent of heaven was to show them
bali bagala kubalaga.
The hopelessness of what they were putting as important.
Obutali mubonno obuli mwecho che bali baloza anti che chikuru.
But the result
na ye byavamu
of this trumpet
mukagombeka
was a hardening of heart.
Byaletera mitima jaba ntatokalubida dala.
Now I want you to watch something.
Ba njagalo labe chino.
The first, when the Bible talks about what was expected, it said they did not repent of the works of their hands, that they should not worship demons.
Bible yetugamba nti baagano okwenenya olw'ebikolwa ebyemikono gyabwe baleme okusinza ebifaananyi.
There is, in theology, what we call the principle of first mention.
Kati mukusoma Bible waliwe nonene yekintu ekisooka okwogerwako.
Basically, it simply means what is mentioned first is more important.
Katugambe ekyo webasooka okwogera ekintu kyekikulu.
All things are listed in the order of importance.
Oba ebintu babiwandiika mu lunyiriri okusinga ku bukulu.
And if you observe,
woba wetegereza
the worship of demons,
okusinza baalubaali,
leads to the idolatry they talk about.
Kireetera abantu kitusindika mu kusinza ebifaananyi kye boogerako.
Praise be to God. It is the demonic influence.
Kweku amaanyi amizimu mabega we amaanyi g'emizimu.
That leads them
agabaleetera abo
into idolatry.
Okutandika okusinza ebifaananyi.
And this explains why they cannot repent.
Kikunnyonnyola lwaki baagaana okwenenya.
You see, they may have begun unknowingly.
Bayinza okuba baatandika mu butanwa.
Or in innocent worship of demons.
Oba baakikola nga tebamanyi gye balaga.
But now that has become entrenched rebellion.
Naye kati ekyo kifuuse bujeemu obw'ekika ekya waggulu.
So nothing can be said. Nothing that is done, not even the trumpets, not even the wars that have been unleashed, are bringing them to that place of repentance. Why? Because every person becomes the image of what or who or she worships.
Praise be to God.
Look at the Bible.
Laba Bible yenu.
In Psalm 115.
Zaburi chikumi kuminatano.
And verse 8.
Noru nyirivomu nana.
Let's go there.
Katugende yo.
This is what the Bible says.
Bible wetu wetu gamba.
Psalm 115.
Zaburi chikumi kuminatano.
And verse 8.
Noru nyirivomu nana.
But I would like us to pick it from verse 1 to understand this. The Bible says,
Bible,
not unto us, not unto us, O Lord.
Sife ai mukama, sife ai mukama.
But your name.
Wabule erinnya lyo.
But your name will give glory.
Wabule erinnya lyo erigwana okuwebwa
ekitiibwa. Because of your mercy.
Olw'okusaasira
kwo. Because of your truth.
N'olw'amazima go.
Why should the Gentiles say?
Lwaki bannamawanga bagamba
nti. So where is their God?
Katonda waabwe ali ludda
wa. But our God is in heaven.
Katonda waffe ali mu ggulu.
He does whatever he pleases.
Akola byonna by'ayagala.
But their idols are silver and gold.
N'ebifaananyi byabwe ye ffeeza ne zaabu.
The work of men's hands.
Omulimu gw'emikono gy'abantu.
They have mouths.
Birina ebimwa.
But they cannot speak.
Naye tebyogera.
Eyes. They have, but they do not see. They have ears, but they do not hear. Noses they have, but they do not smell. They have hands, but they do not handle. Feet they have, but they do not walk. Nor do they matter through their throat. Those who make them,
are
like them.
Bafana
nanga bye bakola. So is everyone.
Era ne muntu yenna
who trusts them.
Atado obwesigebwe mu byo.
What does that mean?
Kitegeza.
That means
kitegeza.
You become
we ofuka
like what you worship.
Ekyo kyonna oba otwala embala n'ekifaananyi kyekyo ky'osinza.
You become who you worship.
Otwala embala y'ekyo kyonna ky'osinza.
That's why the Bible tells us.
Kyeva Bible yetugamba.
And we pick it from Colossians chapter 3.
Mu Bakolosaayi esula ey'okusatu.
Verse 10.
N'olunyiriri lwa 10.
This is what the Bible says.
Bible wetu wetugamba.
If you pick it from verse
9,
it says, do not lie to one another. Since you have put off the old man with his deeds, but have put on the new man, who is renewed in knowledge, according to the image of him who created him. So, the new man is renewed in knowledge according to the what? To the image of him who made him. Now for you to get what this talks about, we go to 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 18. And this is what the Bible tells us. It says, but we all, with unveiled face, beholding, as in a mirror, the glory of the Lord, being transformed in the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. In other words, as we behold Christ, as we revere Christ, as we hold Christ as being most important in our lives, as we follow him, something is happening to us. Remember, whatever grabs your attention grabs you.
Now, chikutwaliramu.
And once it grabs you, it is a potential candidate for worship.
Era we chikutwaliramu chisobola okufuuka ekitonde kyogenda okusinza bakatonda mu bulamu bwo.
So as we behold Christ,
kati we tweyongera okutunulira Kristo,
we are being transformed.
Nafe tutandika okukyusibwa
in the same image.
Mu kufanana nga bwali
of what we are beholding.
Okufanana noyo gwe tutunulidde.
So you're moving from glory to glory.
Kati otandika okutambula ngova mu kitiibwa oyingira kirala.
As you are beholding him,
nga weyongera okumutunulira n'okumwetegereza.
The point I want to make here is that whatever you worship, you become. And we say worship or idolatry comes in when you hold something or someone above God. Praise be to God. Think about it. If you have heard the word of God, and then you hear what is going on in the news, whose report will you believe? If you hold the word of God more important, then you will actually be worshiping God. Jesus said, if you love me, you will keep my word. So, what depicts our love for Christ is our love, is what the attention that we give to the word of God. When we worship Jesus, we become more like him. We reflect his glory. That is what the Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 18. And as we grow from glory to glory, we bear fruit according to John chapter 15 and verse
8.
And then we continue in this journey of beholding him. And we begin to walk as he walked, according to 1 John chapter 2 and verse
6.
The point is this: whatever we revere in life, we resemble. either for ruin,
either chitutwala mukuzikirira,
or for restoration.
Obo kutuza buja.
So we have to be very careful.
Kati tuwelebe gendere.
Because what we worship
chonache tusinza
exposes us.
Chitulaga chiche tuli.
What we worship
chonache tusalawo kusinza
changes us.
Chituchusa.
So if we worship the world,
wetusinze ensi nebijirimu,
then we are conformed to its sinful patterns.
Kati tutwale chifananye chechibi echiri munsi.
If we worship and revere God,
wetusinza katondono,
then we are progressively conformed to his likeness.
Kati tukula mufukufanana ngabwali.
So if your worship
kato kusinza ko
is directed to a dead thing,
wobo sinza chintu chitaina bulamu,
then you become dead.
Now ufuka mufunga bwechidi.
But if your worship is directed to the living God,
ne wobo sinza katondo omulamu,
hallelujah, you become alive.
Ofuka mulamu
and alive.
Ero ofuka mulamu munda muye.
So what is the object of your worship?
Kati gwe okusinza ko kuli osinza chi?
That is the question I want to leave with you.
Che kibuzo chenjagalo kulekera.
That is something I want you to meditate on.
Che chintu chenjagalo fumitirize.
Look around your life.
Wetegereza
obulamu bwo. What is it that you are holding more important than God?
Chichi cho taddeko muwendo kusinga Katonda.
What is it that the Holy Spirit is telling you?
Gwe chichi omwe mtukuvu chakugamba.
That must change.
Chiweta go kuchusa.
Therefore, I would like to take this opportunity to invite you, our listeners, to invite you, our viewers, to go before God
genda maso ga Katonda
and ask him by his Spirit
omusabe okuita mu moyo we
to search you
and
guide you and lead you to the place of repentance. We have seen from the word of God, in this time when the wars came upon these people, rather than repent, rather than turn back to God, they continued their wayward activity. They went back down into idolatry. They sank deeper into idol worship. The Bible says they did not repent of their murders. They continue to murder. They continue their sorceries. They continue their sexual immorality. They continued in their thefts. Let it not be so with you. Today you have this moment. The Bible says, if you hear his word, harden not your heart. This is your moment. Is the Lord speaking to you? This is the moment to make a turnaround. This is the moment that God is inviting you to his mercies. This is the moment that you can come to God and he will clothe you with his grace. This is the moment you can come to him and he will wash and cleanse you. He will close that door and you will be set free in the name of Jesus Christ. Will you join me in prayer? If you are there, you have never given your life to Jesus Christ. You've heard very nice stories about it. You could possibly be able to recite the Bible from cover to cover. What you're lacking is a personal relationship. The Bible tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. The invitation I'm making for you today is the invitation to the person of Christ, that you have a personal relationship. It is simple. changu
nyo. It begins with a simple prayer.
Tandika nesare nyangu.
Of inviting him in your heart.
Okumwaniriza je mu mutima
gwo. Your life will be changed.
Obulamu bugenda kuchuka.
Your life will never be the same.
Tebujja kusigala chechimu.
For all eternity.
Mirembe na mirembe.
Will you join me?
Onatwe gataku.
As we pray.
Ngatusaba.
Father.
Tata.
In the name of Jesus.
Mulinye lya Yesu.
I bring those that are hearing me today.
Ndeta abo naba ampolizo rwale
before you.
Mumaso.
You know the heart of every man.
Omanyi buli ekiri munda mutima
gomo. You know their deepest thoughts.
Omanyi ebirowozo byawe
byonna. You know the intentions of their mind.
Nebigendera byebiri mbirowozo
byawe. You know the works of their hands.
Omanyi ebikolwa byemikono gyawe.
Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus.
Mukama ansabye mulinye lya Yesu.
For those that come before you this day.
Bonna abaze joli olwali.
I pray, Lord.
Saba mukama.
That you stretch forth your hand of mercy.
Golola omukono gwo ogwekisa.
And draw them into your warm embrace.
Obalete mu kifuba.
Father, I thank you.
Tata nkwebaza.
Now, those of you that are committing their lives to Christ, this is your moment. Just say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I am a sinner. I need you, Lord, to save me. I need you, Lord, to wash and cleanse me. I agree and I know that you died at Calvary for my sins. Your blood was shed that I may be cleansed. Today, Lord, I ask you to wash and cleanse me of every sin I've committed, of my sin nature. Make me a child in your house. Lord, I pray. In the name of Jesus. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. That from this day forward, I will be led by you.
That
from this day forward, I will behold you. And not any idol. That you will be the most important person in my life. You will be more important than anything or anyone in my life. Lord Jesus,
Mukama Yesu,
thank you for saving me. Thank you for cleansing me. Thank you for purifying me. Thank you for making me a child of God. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Now, if you made this prayer, you have been wonderfully saved. You call God your Father. When you pray, He hears you. Let this word of God be your stronghold. Begin to read it. Where you don't understand, the Spirit of the Lord will help you. But anchor your faith in this word
of God.
Find a church, a Bible believing church. Become a part of this church. You will be blessed in the fellowship of believers. You will be strengthened. You will grow. You will love the Lord more. And the destiny that God has for your life will be made manifest. This is what he says in Jeremiah 29:11.
He
says, I know the plans I have
for you.
They are plans for good and not for evil. No matter what has happened, this is the beginning. It begins with salvation. It begins with you becoming a child of God. And then we begin that journey. So forth. I'm now going to text this time to pray for those people that are afflicted. For those of you who are in situations that are beyond your means, you are in a situation that is beyond what you can handle. You are in a situation that is beyond
Your thoughts, your imagination.
You need
God to intervene. Let me pray with you. Father, in Jesus' name. With you, there is nothing that is impossible. Even now, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus that you stretch forth your hand. Bring healing, Lord. Bring deliverance, Lord. Bring restoration, Lord. You promised in your word that the years the conqueror has taken, the year the hopping locust has taken, you will restore. I pray for restoration for your people. Restoration financially. I pray for restoration health-wise. I pray for restoration emotionally. I pray for restoration in every aspect of their lives. King of glory and Lord of honor, in the name of Jesus Christ, we decree freedom to your people. In the name of Jesus Christ, we speak healing to your people. In the name of Jesus Christ, we speak freedom in Jesus' name. Be set free in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord of glory. Now, don't forget, we are on YouTube.
YouTube.
Dominion Church International Mbuya.
Dominion Church International Mbuya.
Don't forget, we are on Facebook.
Jukira neko Facebook jetuli.
Dominion Church International Mbuya.
Erache chimu Dominion Church International
Mbuya. Please pay us a visit.
Genda tuchali.
Wonderful messages there.
Obako obujjo kuzama amanyi
jetuli. Your life will not remain the same.
Obulamu bwote bujja kusigala.
Thank you for joining us today.
Mwebale okutwegatta ko olwaleero.
Wish you a wonderful week.
Tubaagaliza week enungi.
From Dominion Church International Mbuya.
Okuveno mu Dominion Church International.
We say God richly bless you.
Mukama abawo omukisa. Amen.